Hello, everybody, and welcome to Bush Hog's comprehensive. I'll take a sip of beer. Review of one of my favorite country songs of all time is Spotlight by David Allan Coe. This will be in the background, will be some footage of Red Dead Redemption because I don't know. That's what I felt like should be there. So, I'm just going to go through the song, pause when I find necessary, and just talk about it. Talk about why I think it is a perfect country song and possibly one of the best country songs of all time. So let's get started.
I can't see nothing but spotlights. Spotlights see nothing but me. All of my music is lonely. Yeah, all of my heartaches were free.
So in the first two lines of the song, we can see that David Allan Coe is essentially, in a what I consider a perfect manner, lining up the song. He's setting it up. It's a strong but slow intro, if that makes sense. And he's showing you in these first two lines that this song is going to be about what's going on in his head. This is how he feels. And that automatically gives it a very honest and real feeling. You feel like this isn't some song that he made to sell. This is a song he made to express himself, which is obviously a key trait to any perfect country song. Let's continue.
Don't waste your time or your flash balls. Too many heroes are dead. You like to live in the city. Yeah, I like to live in my head.
Okay, so in the second two lines, he basically reiterates this. He says, don't waste your time or your flashbulbs, meaning cameras, because too many heroes are dead, talking about older, real country musicians, Hank Sr., those kinds of guys, the old guys, and talking about how most new country fans don't really even live in the country, and how he spends a lot of his time just thinking about who he is. And I think that this is him comparing himself to other country artists of his time, being, you know, the George Jones, Merle Haggard, Hank Jr. I think Hank Jr. was a little bit later. But people in those timelines, don't get me wrong, they're great artists, but they're not David Allan Coe. David Allan Coe is a different breed of country artist, and he is basically coming out with this song in a way where he wants to express his feelings about that. And this is where he basically just rolls the song right into this eccentric course. Just a really hard hitter, in my opinion. Let's go ahead and hear it out. Alright, so, I'm going to pause right there. Now let's go over this course. So, somebody shoot out the spotlight. The spotlight is on him. Now, a key thing to keep in mind is when there's a spotlight shining on you while you're on a stage, you really can't see the crowd. So, this is almost giving David a feeling of loneliness, if that makes sense, when he feels like, which he goes on to reinforce in the rest of the song. He wants to be and wants to express himself as more or less the same as everybody else. I'm one of you. I'm a redneck. I'm an outlaw. I'm a, you know, a cowboy. You know, don't think of me as some kind of larger than life figure. And where I really think that he cements this idea is in the line, "Roll me a smoke, give me some coke, and treat me like I'm alive." Because all country music stars of this era, Hank Jr., George Jones, probably Willie Nelson, who knows who else, most of them, they were all doing massive amounts of drugs, smoking weed, which isn't a big deal, insane amounts of alcohol. We know this with George Jones. But when it came to the hardest one, which was the hard drugs, as in coke, they never spoke of it in their songs, or at least not to my knowledge, and not out front with it. Mr. Coe is coming out and he's saying, look, I'm not this superstar that you have to put me on this throne. I want you to just treat me like a regular person. Fucking give me a couple of lines, you know, roll me up a fucking joint, and let's hang out. Let's have a good time. I'm here to have a good time as much as I am to entertain you. He's doing what he does because he loves it and he wants to express himself, not because he's simply trying to make money and sell a record. And he kind of wraps it up in this last line of the chorus, saying that everyone's lying about living, and everybody's living a lie, saying that these other country singers, not necessarily, I don't think he's being disrespectful to them, but I think he's saying that they're letting their career basically mask who they really are, you know, where everything they do behind the scenes, they're supposed to be a musician where they express themselves and who they are. And you know, most of them can't do that because they're under some kind of, you know, weird record contract that says that they're not allowed to say fuck on a song. And, hang on, I got a burp. So, I think that this is really, I don't know how to say it, just expressive of David to come out with these hard words and just real honesty in this song. So we're going into the bridge now, and then he's going to go into the second verse, which we'll listen to. Alright, now that second verse for me has always been a whopper, because in the first verse, he really compares himself to what I think is other country singers. In the second verse, he actually compares himself to the audience, to the people that watch him, and, you know, they think that he's some superstar and, you know, just somebody really great, which he is. But he doesn't want them to feel that way, saying that he spends his night times in mourning, like sad mourning, and he spends his mornings alone. And basically they spent their money just to come and see him, to watch him play. And he spends the money that they give him basically just getting fucked up. So then now he uses this to transfer into a... I want you to understand that I really think we're the same kind of people here, when he says, now that we're both kind of busted, we've both spent all our money, you know, doesn't it seem kind of strange? I'll just read the lyrics. I lay down knowing that we're two of a kind, and you'll leave here knowing my name, which, I don't know, for me, that hits home, you know, because he's really trying to come out and just say, hey, I know that you think I'm this guy that you can't talk to, or you can't party with me, or, you know, can't come up to me and pass me a beer or whatever, but we're really the same people. I'm just up here on the stage and you happen to be in the audience, but in reality it could be reverse. And basically we need to hang out. We need to have fun, because this is David Allan Coe's being incarcerated for most of his life. I feel like this is country music is where he found his home, and not so much in the idea of making country music a career, but expressing himself through country music and being part of the community of country music, not in the sense of famous singers all hanging out, in the sense of, you know, I sing, I'm done, and then we can all party afterwards, and that's like his family to him. And I just really think that this is one of the most heartfelt, amazing 10 out of 10 country songs there is. And I'm going to let my little commentary, my rant, finish off with the course of the song.